Hello viewers, I welcome you all to Technology Learning Space YouTube channel. In this video, you are going to watch how to replace your vCenter server certificate using your own CA. This is a simple and complete video on how to create an internal CA using Microsoft certificate service for a VMware vCenter. Installation is not a straight task, but following demonstration will help you to do it more easier. Some of the prerequisites are here. You need a vCenter server, Microsoft Certificate Authority, PuTTY and WinCSP. For more understanding and easiness, I just split all the steps comes in it into 5 steps. The first one is install Microsoft Certificate Authority. In second step, we will customize the template for vSphere as per vSphere VMware standard. In third step, we will generate a certificate sign-in request CSR from vCenter, and then we will submit that CSR into Microsoft Certificate Authority. Once we download the certificate from Microsoft Certificate Authority, then we will import this certificate into VMware vCenter. Now let's watch the demonstration. Choose a domain controller or one of your Windows server to make it a certificate authority. For this, click add roles and select Active Directory certificate services. Click add feature, then complete the wizard. Here there is two things you have to select. One is certificate authority and second one is certificate authority web enrollment. Click install and complete the installation. Once we complete the installation of certificate service feature, the next part is to configure this role. For this, you will see a post deployment configuration. Click configure Active Directory certificate service. Click next, select certification authority and certification authority web enrollment. Follow the selections and complete the wizard. Now the Active Directory certificate service configuration is complete. Now the second part is how to configure the template as per VMware vSphere document. Open run and then type the following. Scroll down and select web server and duplicate template. Here you can see in the compatibility tab you have to change it to Windows 2008, and for the certificate recipient you can select Windows 8.1 or later. Click OK. In general, you can rename this template, so this we will identify this name when we submit the CSR and download the certificate. You can increase the validity to 5 years. In extension from the application policies, just check the server authentication is there. And select the last one, then key usage. Click edit. And select the second option also, then click OK. The security tab give permission for the administrator to enroll also. Then click OK. So customizing a template for vCenter has completed. So now let us move to the third point. The third step is to generate a certificate signing request from vCenter. This is done through command prompt. So for this, we need PuTTY. From PuTTY, I just connect to my vCenter and log in with root credentials. Once you log in, if this is first time you log in, you have to follow this command to enable the shell. Okay, so once you have a shell access, then you need to run. Once you have shell access, then the next step is to run the certificate manager. So you can see the first step is replace machine SSL certificate with a custom certificate. So select for option one and give the credentials. So the first step, generate certificate signing request. Yes, I want to configure the file and here give your values. The first thing you have to notice is the country should be two letter. IP address is optional. I just give my IP address. Then host name is your host name for the vCenter server. Here mine is vcenter.nasitpro.com. VMCA name is the same as your full qualification domain name of your vCenter, so just complete it with the same name. Okay, so once you complete, then the next step is to create a certificate with the key now generated. So for this, I already connected my vCenter with WinSCP. So I just copy the VMCA issued key and also VMCA issued a certificate signing request to my Windows server. Now I'm going to submit this CSR to the certificate authority that we earlier created. Click on request a certificate, advance a certificate and select vSphere 6.0. This is what we created in the template. Make sure you select base 64 encoded, then download the certificate. And you have to download the CA certificate also. And here also you have to make sure you selected base 64. So now we have both the certificate. Just rename the certificate for an understanding. Root CA. And the first one machine CA. Now copy these two certificates back to vCenter. I selected both and just copy to vCenter. Now let's go back to PuTTY. Here the options are in front of us is continue to import the custom certificate. So press 1 to do that. The first one is machine SSL. So just give the exact name of the certificate. Second name is the key name that was generated. You can see it here. It's VMCA issued key, so just rename to avoid make mistakes. Okay, and finally the root certificate. It's root ca.cer. Okay, then press yes. And this process may take less than 1 minute. Now the certificate update has completed, so it's time to verify the certificate installation. Open your vCenter URL from browser. Here you can see there is no security warning, and can just click on certificate and verify the certificate. Click view certificate and find details. You will see the certificate is issued by the certificate authority that we were installed. So that's all about SSL certificate installation for vCenter server. Thank you for watching this video. For more videos, subscribe this channel or visit niasitpro.com.